think firstly to explain to you the people who worked on the credentials, myself and the head of our organizing division, Fikile Malula, together with the 9 provincial secretaries, one from every province, and that's the norm in the ANC. Nobody works on their own. We had to delay the credentials by a day, given the outcome of the court on KwaZulu-Natal and the Free State, and also Bujanala region in Northwest. That the issues there, we have decided that the PECs of KZN and Free State, those who are not branch delegates already, would not become voting delegates, so that we comply with the judgment of the court. 35 branches of the Northwest were also disqualified as voting delegates. And you will understand that that takes a bit of work, because you also have to explain to the branches why they're being disqualified, and it is a court order, and that you're withdrawing their delegation status. So all those people had to be converted into non-voting delegates. They can participate, but they're not going to be able to vote. Similarly, with the Free State, the PEC members who were not branch delegates are also non-voting delegates, as are 14 branches who had fairly substantial delegations. So that did create a difficulty. However, we've managed it, and we've reported that to plenary, and it was accepted. The branches have been withdrawn. We've also withdrawn categories of delegations across the board of people who did not pass what we call a verification process, which is a process of ensuring that indeed there was a BGM, a branch general meeting, that sat and that indeed had elected a delegation. And few people from that category had also been disqualified. There was also a find that about, it was mainly Eastern Cape and also Western Cape, small numbers of people who had been left out by mistake. Two branches. They were disqualified by the verification process. We found they came, they appealed, found all the documentation, they were able to provide proof, and they were reinstated. So, you know, credentials is not just about nodding your head, it's about actually checking very thoroughly who the credentials are and what they're about, and that's what we were doing. There was no inflation whatsoever of the numbers. I really honestly sorry have to say that. I've been reading all of this every day, and I've been wondering where this is coming from. However, let me pass that. No. In fact, instead of having the component of voting delegates, which would have been over 5,000, if you took branch delegates, included your PECs, your leagues, you would have been over 5,000. We now stand at approximately 4,700. So it's lower than the number that should have been there to vote. I don't know what else, Comrade Zizi, that's what verification is about. The point that I do want to make to you is that it's not unusual to delay credentials. We do it for the credibility of the process, so that, as you well know, this is the one point that people use to have court interdicts and court cases and injunctions, and we've been extremely careful not to open any possibility that would take us in that direction. So, number one, stay true to the branch mandated delegate, and that's what we wanted to prove, and we have, to 90% of the case. The other percentage, of course, is what the courts did to compel us to remove branch delegates, and we're living with that. And I can say to you that the credentials have been adopted.
Okay. 16.
Okay. Okay. So the rest of the program for will be as follows. We're still in a closed session now where we're adopting the rules of the conference first. You need credentials to do that. The second issue is there are proposals for changes to the ANC's constitution, and we needed credentials for that. So those are the two matters that are currently being debated and discussed. Thereafter, we will open at some point for an open session where nominations for the top six positions will be put forward. If there are changes, for instance, if there is an acceptance of an expanded top six, then those would be added in. And beyond that, our Independent Election Commission will go and develop a ballot paper, and we hope to start voting at some point later this afternoon, hopefully, and have those results as it now stands, possibly by tomorrow morning. We don't rush results. We'd like them to do a thorough and proper job. To get our voters to the voting station, we've approximated about 200 people per round. And that means for 4,700 people, it could take a long time. And that's what we have to do. So the program will go that way, and then followed by the organizational report of the Secretary General. Hopefully we can squeeze that in, even if it is late into the night. We've already had messages of support. We will have messages of support by our alliance partners tomorrow as well, and also another input on organizational renewal, and then we'll have a go into commissions. And so the work of conference, we're hoping we can be done on Wednesday night.